Now, for the operation of matrices, we have done the first part. First part was addition of a matrices. Okay. And after doing the addition of a matrices, we have done properties based on the addition of the matrices. That was commutative property, associative property, additive inverse, and additive identity. Okay. Now we are on the scalar multiplication of a matrix. Now, what scalar multiplication means? Scalar means a number. A number can be a real or an imaginary. Okay. So let's move first with a very nice definition for the scalar multiplication of a matrix. Now, suppose we are having a matrix A of order m cross n. Okay. So a matrix A of order m by n, this is all any, it can be of any order, a matrix A of order m by n, and k is a scalar number. Again, k can scalar number can be real or imaginary. Okay, and k is a scalar number, then scalar multiplication is defined to be of order, now this is it is defined to be the order of m cross n, means we are not changing the order. If order is m cross n, here also it is m cross n. Then scalar multiplication is defined to be of order m cross n of a matrix whose elements are obtained, by multiplying by k, you can say of. Okay. Now, what this means? What exactly this means? A matrix A of order m by n, and k is a scalar number. Then scalar multiplication. Then from here, then scalar multiplication is defined to be of order m cross n. Of a matrix whose elements are obtained by multiplying by k of matrix A. Okay, whose elements, what this means? Elements means every element of the matrix. Okay, now let's take a example. We are having, if it is given A is equal to 2, 4, let it be a row matrix. Now A is 2, 4, scalar is a number, so we have to find 3a. Now what 3 is? 3 is k. 3 is a scalar number. Okay. So if we have to find 3a, then 3a is equal to 3, 2, 4, and further this will be 6 and 12. Means 3 multiplied by 2 and 3 multiplied by 4. 3 will be multiplied by every number. Okay. Suppose now after this we are having, if now this was of only single row matrix. Okay. Now suppose we are having A is equal to, now this is a matrix for order, how many rows are there? 2 rows. How many columns? 3 columns. So this is for 2 by 3. Now again we have to find, suppose we have to find 4A. If you have to find 4A, then again 4A is equal to 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2 cross 3. Now every element of the matrix will be multiplied by 4. So the result will be, now what is the result? The result will be 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 64. Means 4 multiplied by 1, by 2, by 3, then by 4, then by 5, then by 6. So this is called scalar multiplication. Okay. Now after scalar multiplication with this very nice definition, we are going to now proceed with the properties. Okay. So to this part you can write it K A is equal to K A I J of order m cross n. It can be written like this also. Okay.